had in that block a 16-year-old move to North Wales and then returned. He had been organising the drug dealing gang, a 16-year-old, who isn't responsible enough to be put in jail. And I think that's really worrying. So I think that all the comments made, if those two incidents just in a couple of weeks is true, it really does show. Government, as a Liberal, made of Rome, we've always had a constant to our beliefs, believing in society where people have liberty, property, and security. And if you don't have security, you don't have liberty. When people are having to flee their homes and sell their homes because of fear that drug dealers are going unchallenged, and violence against the person when they stand up to protect their neighbourhood, then society got it wrong. This government got it wrong. I just hope when you do have a demonstration, like the one outside your, you do include all embracing, including all the parties.
Okay, can you imagine, Councillor? Thank you very much.
Thank you. Does anybody else want to speak on the amendment? Are you speaking on the... No. Is the amendment acceptable?
No, no, Lord Mayor. I can't accept the amendment two pieces. It's that you absorb what kind of thought level is that in some senses it is, can be seen as a criticism of the police. It's like the resources that the police have got that's resulted in them, so I'm not prepared to accept it. I know that there's, you know, people talk to me who work for the police, who actually spoke to me, and said that there's good discharges within the city that doesn't go reported because the police don't respond when someone rings up and tells them that there's been a gun discharge, so we don't even get it reported. But the fact that we know there's been 50-odd gun discharges within the city, that's what we know of. There's plenty of others that I'm sure we don't know of, and that's a real concern, but this shouldn't be seen as a criticism of the police. It's a criticism of the lack of funding to the police that gives that. I know maybe that's not your intention. That's how it looks, so we're not rejecting that. And I thank you for your support.
We move straight to the vote on the amendment. Are those for the amendment? I think we have 2-4.
Yeah.
Those against the amendment? Overwhelming majority. And there's 4 abstentions. You can do the maths. Right, we were the call Councillor Conception and Councillor Rodney and Councillor Miller. And I don't. Are you insisting, Councillor Cushing? Okay, well, Councillor Cushing, and that's what I'll call him, Mr. Clay. Okay.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. When I was elected for my ward at Hugh Street, one of the pledges I made that I would be a strong voice for our community. And it does seem to me that today, with the Mayor's motion, this is one of those occasions that we need to speak out on behalf of our local residents. First of all, I'd like to praise the police and our emergency services who risk their lives every day to keep us safe. I think it's important that we acknowledge that. In my ward, there was a shooting last week, and I think in the city, there were 7 shootings within 10 days. And this morning, we had our problem-solving group, and we had our neighbourhood police officer there. And I asked them, what are the effects on the cuts to policing in our ward? And he said, they've had a massive effect, not only in our ward, but across the city. In fact, he was sorry, as a police officer, that they couldn't provide the service that we deserve, our community deserve. He was full of sorrow. He gives examples of some of the things that are going on. In our ward, as the mayor said, he chased a van that was driven by a 14-year-old boy who was equipped with a thief-making equipment. He managed to escape. But this is what's going on in our city, in our wards. I think every ward in the city can give examples of scrambler bikes who will go around terrorising the neighbourhood. People are afraid to report it because they fear reprisals. And we all know that what they need to do is to report it, and you can do it anonymously. And we've got to get that message out. So this motion today It should be supported by all our councillors today. Austerity, as Councillor Mitchell said and the Mayor has said, is something that is ruining our country, and the message has got to go home to this government. Enough is enough. They're not listening. We've got to make them listen. We've got to be the voice of our police force and our emergency services. So I urge everybody today to go and support the motion.
Well spoken, Councillor Conception. Councillor Rothery.
Sorry, everybody's sitting on your knees today. I mean, I think it just echoes what everybody's feeling around the chamber. It's a sad indictment in terms of my ward. My ward is notorious to not having the greatest relationship with the police in the past. However, at a time when my ward and my community really need the assistance of the police, they're not there because they can't be there because of this government and the cruel cuts that they've made across the entire country. The community in my ward, we've all had gunfire and shots and people shot at, but the community in my ward is still reeling from the death of Yusuf Sanko. His father, for peace, Sanko, has dedicated his life to educating the children in our community, not just in Liverpool, but across the city. His mother, Khadija, is one of the most upstanding women and committed women that I know. Yusuf was on his way to university. He had a good house at Liverpool Lakes and he had a future to look forward to. And that, unfortunately, was taken away from him. I just want to go on record to say that Yusuf was a fine, upstanding citizen with his whole life ahead of him. At a time when the community pulled together to bring justice for Yusuf Sanko, the police resources were minimal because of the cuts. They did what they could with the limited expertise and limited resources at their disposal. But the community came together to make sure justice was done for his death. Just as cruelly, at the same time that happened, the youth service, was cut from this government again. The youth service that does the intervention to work with our young people, the dilutionary tactics to move them away from a life of crime, was also cut. Joe spoke earlier on about older men and women who try to get our young people into a life of crime and drug dealing. Unfortunately, this is seen day in and day out, not just across the city, but nationally. In order to break the cycle, we need to have the contribution of not just the police service, but from the youth service. And we need to break the cycle, otherwise we are condemning our young people to a life of misery, a life where they are taught to go and sell drugs and go into a life of crime is a better way than going and finding a job or getting an education. Some people might say that the cuts to the police force will have a minimal impact on this, but we forget about the policemen who do the work on the streets. We have an amazing police officer, community police officer in our ward, who goes above and beyond the call of duty every single day. He does work with parents, he does work with children, youth service, community organisations. So when we talk about police cuts, we're not just using the core cuts to the police as we know it, the matrix, and other traditions from the service, we're also losing our people on the streets who have that direct route into communities. And we have to stand up and say, this is just not up for debate anymore. We have to stand up and say, put our money back where we need it. You're messing with the life of our children and their future.
Well said. I think all contributors for their brevity and preciseness. Councillor Miller.
I'll try and be brief on that. Thank you. In October 2008, Joseph Lappin, a resident of Old Swan, was stabbed to death. And every year, Old Swan remembers his life. And as a legacy statement, we now have the Joseph Lappin Centre, and we have the Joseph Lappin Festival, of which the police come and the fire and rescue service come, and the community comes. And this year, we had the highest attendance ever, with several thousands in the Lord Mayor who were there. And that's to remember Joseph, but to actually remember that who had to fight against crime, knife crime and gun crime. And yet, in Old Swan last week, in Derby Lane, in a shop that has had its third robbery attack in less than a year, a new shop owner is now threatening to leave because he was attacked with a gun and a machete in Old Swan. The police came straight away and the police did a fantastic job, and the neighbourhood inspector is wonderful, as are his officers. But there's been a huge increase in crime in Old Swan. In just 6 months, we've had in excess of 300 different elements of crime. Many are reported, many are not. There are idiots and tow rags racing around on scramble brakes, and actually I've got to say, the police have done an amazing job in reducing those incidents by 32%. Need to do more. But there's some people in Old Swan and elsewhere storing these bikes in alleys, etc. And we're now relying on increased community intelligence, but people are struggling to get through on 101. Some will not report it because they're being called grassies, and the community is actually going against those that wish to report issues of crime. People are climbing into alleyways, they are breaking into backyards, and that's a reason for many of the new crimes in the last year. And then you discover it's only less than 10 people. And that needs more investigation. So all the police are doing an amazing job under very difficult circumstances. Austerity is hitting Old Swan worse than it's ever been. And I really do worry massively about not having the police officers available that I know the neighbourhood inspector and I know the chief constable wants to give us. Let's do more and let's write to this government and tell them we have to do something for the city. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. Final speaker, Councillor Bishop.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'll be brief. Just to add another element to what we're talking about in terms of the impact of police cuts, is the impact that it has in terms of the social care of our own children. So we are